Okay, let's look at hydroboration alkyne addition. So if we're looking at a terminal alkyne, end of the chain, hydrogen on the end, we're going to use exclusively a derivatized borane reagent that will have two carbon R groups. One of the more commonly used groups that you may see would be the 9-BBN reagent. You can look that up. Okay, there's hundreds of these for sale at different chemical suppliers that do a single BH addition, okay, not the three that we're used to seeing for borane. So for terminal alkyne, we'll use this type of reagent, NTHF, followed by the same second step where we add peroxide, hydroxide, and water. And what do we get? What makes it special? It's antimarkovnikov. And we get an aldehyde, okay, and we can draw it right side up to be the way we normally would put it, okay, an aldehyde, and again, skeletal structure, the H is not necessary, and so we get something a little different than normal. Now, with our internal alkyne, it's very similar to an acid-catalyzed hydration, okay, or a mercury-catalyzed hydration, where we form ketones. And we can use 9-BBN or BH3 for these. The greater steric hindrance prevents multiple additions by the borane, which are possible with the extra pi bond. And what do we get? We get ketones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons, count them up. And with a non-symmetrical alkyne, we have two possible products, so very similar to before. Now, what about the mechanism? Well, let's look at the terminal alkyne. So anti-Markovnikov would put the more bulky substituent to the outside, empty p orbital of boron, and then we dump from the BH bond into a new CH bond, and we form our first intermediate structure in a syn addition. And when we do that, we force up the R group. Okay, at this point, we're pretty much the same as our other hydroboration mechanism for alkenes, and so we then take deprotonated peroxide, dump into the empty p orbital of boron, and form our complex. Highlighting our weak peroxide bond, where the driving force for this is the breaking of that bond. And as we remove the pair of electrons from this oxygen, we must fill those, and we do that by a rearrangement of types where we invert the boron and the oxygen, and then we start to look more like our alcohol, our enol that we're trying to form. And then we lose a hydroxide. So at this point, we are now, from this point on, going to consider ourselves to be in equilibrium after the irreversible step. And we add to the empty orbital of boron, forming another complex. Again, remember my -1 formal charge there on boron. Can't forget that. And as we add our hydroxide, form another -1 formal charge on boron. And this boron complex can leave, dumping its electrons onto oxygen, forming our enolate. And our enolate can tautomerize in basic conditions, forming a carbonyl, breaking the pi bond, carbon to carbon, which then grabs a hydrogen from water. And we form our aldehyde.